This is not about age, and you know it.
It's about you flying a goddamn computer console when you want to be out there hopping galaxies.
You're hiding behind rules and regulations.
Who am I hiding from?
From yourself, Admiral.
I know you don't like celebrating it on the day, because it's also the day your paw bit the dust.
I'm 1 year older. A year older than he ever got to be. He joined Starfleet because he believed in it. I joined on a dare.
You joined to see if you could live up to him. Now you're wondering just what it means to be Jim.
Yeah, that's totally not the same thing at all.
Hasn't Star Trek suffered enough? Simon Kinberg in talks to produce Star Trek movie franchise for Paramount. Okay, so in my lifetime, all 30 plus years of it, that means at the cinema I have seen the end of Real Trek, the beginning of Abrams Trek, the conclusion of Abrams Trek, and now we'll see another continuation of that same rebooted Trek. Paramount is really tapping into the, Disney Star Wars way of thinking, aren't they?
Let the past die.
The multi-hyphenate, okay, is in talks to produce a Star Trek feature for Paramount Pictures. If all goes well, the door would open. No, that should read will open. Who taught this organization how to write grammatically accurate sentences? Jesus Christ.
It's okay. You're allowed one mistake.
The door will open to him taking active creative roles on the rest of the storied franchise's film side. Alex Kurtzman and Akiva Goldsman are the main creative producers on Star Trek's television side. They just had to put that last little part to add further salt to the wound, didn't they? Yeah.
Bastards. Bastard-coated bastards with bastard filling.
The project Kinberg would step into is already in very active development. Toby Haynes, who directed episodes of the Star Trek series Andor? Seriously, does anybody proofread these things anymore?
Strike two.
Is on board to direct the new feature, with Seth Graham Smith writing the script. No, I don't know who he is either, but a quick glance at his Wikipedia page saw something mighty disturbing. The project is set to be set decades before the events of the 2009 movie that was directed by J.J. Abrams, likely around modern times. No.
Nah.
It is said to involve the creation of the Starfleet and humankind's, mankind's, first contact with alien life. Yeah, we did that. It's called First Contact.
Live long and prosper.
Thanks.
Doesn't this movie stink of modern times? And what I mean by that is, it's another prequel to a rebooted franchise that should never have existed in the first place. Led by people who don't understand Trek from any sort of nuanced perspective, who don't understand the subtleties of character interaction. For example, like how they utilize Kirk and Spock.
You'll flood the whole compartment to die.
Sir, he's dead already.
Spock!
Ship out of danger?
Yes.
Don't grieve, Admiral. The needs of the many outweigh
the needs of the few.
Or the one. I have been and always shall be your friend.
No. Open it.
The decontamination process is not complete. You'd flood the whole compartment.
Out of danger.
It was only logical. I'm scared, Spock. How do you choose not to feel?
I do not know. Right now, I am failing.
Buried alive.
In Wrath of Khan, Spock dies. He dies a hero and does so while maintaining his emotional restraint, as control of emotions is vital to a Vulcan state of mind. It's the essence of their culture. In Star Trek Into Darkness, however, Abrams is so unable to grasp the subtle nature that he decides to make Spock reenact a scene from Hamlet.
Nay, then I'll set those to you that can speak.
Kinberg rose to prominence thanks to his writing and producing work on Fox's X-Men franchise, over whose course, and in due course, dear Lord,
are you freaking kidding me?
He took creative control and even made his directorial debut with Dark Phoenix. Oh, fuck.
And by the way, the women are always saving the men around here. You might want to think about changing the name to X-Women.
Why do they? Why? Anyway, he has also worked on movies ranging from Murder on the Orient Express to The Martian, as well as select Star Wars projects. Yes, those Star Wars projects, as they so cryptically put, would be a thank you credit on Rogue One and being the creator of this for excuse show.
You really do shoot like a stormtrooper. Guess I don't have too much to worry about.
This helmet. I can't see.
Why? You little piece of dribble piss.
And he worked with Graham Smith before as co-screenwriter and executive producer on his adaptation of Abraham Lincoln Vampire Hunter. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Really?
Really, really.
This is the crack writing team that will handle Star Trek movies? Well, what do I expect? They let the destroyer of franchises near it, then they let his disciple lead the television era. Why not a couple of f**tards too? Amazon did this with The Rings of Power, so why not here too? It's the winning formula! R.I.P. Star Trek, R.I.P. Star Wars, R.I.P. Lord of the Rings, and of course, coming courtesy every Saturday now, R.I.P. Doctor Who. Everything we loved has gone down the shitter. All that is left is the memes. The glorious memes. The finding humor out of crap period has begun. What a sorry excuse of an entertainment era we are in. Anyway, hope you enjoyed the video. I seem to be ending more and more videos this way, laughing at the absurdity of it all. Anyway, guys, I'll probably be back on Saturday with you know who. So until then, take care.